CIET-NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 8.
Hello children, how are you? I hope you are enjoying your time in activities, you are staying at home, but I'm going to expect you happy and peaceful. Myself Vinod Bala, I'll be your team member for this chapter today. I'll take NCERT class 8 chapter 1 today. It is rational numbers and we are just going to talk about the family of numbers today. Let us just recap about the family of numbers. Can you name some of the members of this family? Try. Yes, I want to hear you. You can try. Exactly, you told me right. Natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, and rational numbers. Very good. In the beginning, we started counting articles by using numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Try to name this family of numbers. Think. Yes, try. Natural numbers. Correct. Very right. You told me the correct answer. The smallest natural number is 1. Can you tell me the largest natural number? You told me there does not exist the largest natural number. Why? Why there does not exist the largest natural number? Let us think in this direction. Because every natural number has the successor of it. That is the correct answer. Now, what if we add 0 to the family of natural numbers? We are going to extend the family of natural numbers by the new member that is known as 0. Can you tell me the name of this family now? Again think, try. Yes, this family is the family of whole numbers. Do you know the smallest member of this family? Yes, it is 0. Can you tell me the largest whole number? No. Why there does not exist the largest whole number? Because every whole number has the successor of it. What if we add the negative numbers to the family of whole numbers? Just think about this new family where we have negative numbers, we have 0 and we have natural numbers also. All together, try to think the name of this family. Try. Oh, wow, you told me integers. Exactly. This is the family of integers. You know the smallest natural number. You know the smallest whole number also. Can you try to tell me the smallest integer? No, there does not exist the smallest integer. Can you tell me the reason? Yes. Because we don't have the largest natural number and largest whole number, that is why there does not exist the least integer. If we know the largest whole number, in that case we can put the negative sign and we can just get the least integer. But since there does not exist the largest whole number, hence there does not exist the least integer. Okay, when we operate division sign, that is division operation on integers, what type of numbers do we get? For example, if we divide 5 by 7, we have the numbers of the type 5 by 7. Again, if we divide 7 by 11, we get the result 7 by 11. If we divide 13 by 2, we get the result 13 by 2. Let us try to name these type of numbers. Come on, try. Yes, the name of this family of numbers is rational numbers. Now, let us try to define rational numbers. Rational numbers are the numbers of the type P by Q. But be careful, Q should not be equal to 0. Let us think why q should not be equal to 0. If we just put q to be equal to 0, in that case we have to divide the number by 0. But since division by 0 is not defined, that is not possible, that is why we are not going to take q to be equal to 0. Hence, we define the rational numbers as the numbers of the type p by q, where strictly q should not be 0. Let us now add any two rational numbers. If we add any two rational numbers, what do you think? What will be the answer? Will it be a rational number? You are right. We are just going to get a rational number. So, can you name this property? What we call this property? By adding two rational numbers, the result is a rational number. We call this property as closure property of addition of rational numbers. Now, let us think, is the closure property true for subtraction of rational numbers? Let us try to see. Keep your notebooks ready, or when you are just free, you can just apply this for yourself. Take any two rational numbers and try to subtract one number from another. Yes, the difference is always a rational number. So, we can conclude here that subtraction of two rational numbers is following closure property, because every time we are getting a rational number by subtraction. Now, let us talk about closure property of rational numbers under multiplication. Means, we are just trying, if we multiply any two rational numbers, do we get a rational number every time? Try. Yes, take so many examples. You can play. You can just try by taking different rational numbers. Every time, we are just getting the product of any two rational numbers as a rational number. Hence, multiplication is closed for rational numbers. Now we can think for division. Try and just tell me, if you divide any rational number by other, are you getting a rational number every time? Think, if we are just going to take a rational number 5 by 7, if we divide it by 1, we are getting the same rational number. But is it possible every time? Let us take another example. For example, the same rational number 5 by 7 is divided by 0. Are you getting the rational number? No. Because if we are going to simplify it, then 5 by 7 division sign will be converted into multiplication, and we will write reciprocal of the number which follows the division sign, and 0 will be in the denominator in that case. That is not defined. We are just going to conclude from this example that closure property doesn't hold for division in rational numbers. Now, let us think for next property, that is known as commutativity. First, let us develop the understanding about commutativity. Like in natural numbers, we added two natural numbers in any order. If we have two natural numbers A and B, then we can add A plus B or B plus A, we got the same number. Likewise, here also, if we have two rational numbers A by B and C by D, we can add them in any order. A plus A by B plus C by D is equal to C by D plus A by B. This is known as commutative property for addition of rational numbers. Now we want to check whether this property holds for subtraction or not. For addition, this property holds. For subtraction, let us try. Take two rational numbers. Try to subtract. Like, you can take 1 by 2, a rational number, other rational number, you can take of your choice or you can take 3 by 5. Let us subtract 1 by 2 minus 3 by 5. And then let us change the side. 3 by 5 minus 1 by 2. These two numbers are different. 1 by 2 minus 3 by 5 is not equal to 3 by 5 minus 1 by 2. So, subtraction is not commutative. Let us try to check now commutativity for multiplication. Be careful, children. You can take more examples. One or two examples are not enough to understand the property. For the multiplication, we can take again the rational numbers of the type A by B and C by T. We can multiply them in any order. Let me first multiply A by B and C by D. Or if I multiply C by D and A by B, I'm just getting the two results same. Means you can multiply rational numbers in any order, you are getting the same result. So the conclusion here is commutative property holds for the multiplication of rational numbers. Let us check commutative property for division of rational numbers. Let us take general two rational numbers. A by B is the first rational number and C by D is the second rational number. Then A by B divided by C by D may not be equal to C by D divided by A by B. We can take the particular rational numbers also, like if we divide 1 by 2 by 1 by 3. The result is not equal to the division 1 by 3 divided by 1 by 2. Hence, we can conclude here division is not commutative for rational numbers. Now, it is riddle time. Don't get bored. I have just brought a riddle for you. You are just going to enjoy it. Your mom gave you a rupee 100 note. Everyone, you can just take the duplicate currency. Your mom has given each of you a 100 rupee note. You have to just return 100 rupees to your mom. But there are two conditions. Be careful. You have to return 10 loose notes. Condition 1. Condition 2 is in those 10 notes, there should not be a single 10 rupee note. There should be total 10 notes, but 10 rupee note should not be there. Is it clear? Riddle is clear? Try and send me the answer. Now, time for us to get the answers of the riddle. See, there can be more than one answer. So first, it is tried by one child from your class only. He returned one note of 50 to his mom, one note of rupees 20, and there were 5 notes of 5, 2 notes of rupees 2, and 1 note of rupee 1. In this way, he returned 10 notes to his mother and a total of rupees 100. He tried one more way also. In that case, he just took one note of rupees 50, 2 notes of rupees 20, 3 notes of rupees 2 each, and 4 notes of rupee 1. In that case also, there were 10 notes and a sum of rupees 100. So, he was excited. He tried that there can be more ways, and his ways are also important. You can think for other ways also. Let us just play with 0 and with 1. We are just going to have fun with numbers. I just want to recall my childhood, and I'm also playing with numbers. let me just think for a number which is added to the rational number, but the number is not changed. Can you tell me such number? Try. Correct, it is 0. If I add 0 to any rational number, the sum will be that rational number only. Can you name this property? You have seen, when 0 is added to a rational number, then the rational number remains the same. The name of this property is, or you can say, 0 is called the identity for addition of rational numbers. 0 is the additive identity for integers and whole numbers as well. Can you think for any number by which rational numbers are multiplied and the number remains the same? Here I have said multiplied. Previously we were thinking for addition, but now we have to think for product. Yes, try. Very true, it is 1. If we multiply any rational number by 1, the rational number remains the same. What we call this property? It is multiplicative identity. Very right. So if 1 is multiplied by any rational number, it remains same and it is the multiplicative identity for rational numbers. Now let us try to apply these identities in different situations. Situation 1 is, let us think for additive inverse. Find additive inverse of minus 3 by 4. Think. Tell me, how can you find? Oh, very right. If the sum of two rational numbers is 0, then each one is known as additive inverse of other. Here, we have to find the additive inverse of minus 3 by 4. You have to think for a rational number which is to be added to minus 3 by 4 and the result should be 0. Correct, it is 3 by 4. Can you just think in other way? Let us take another example and let us try to think in different ways. Find additive inverse of 2/117. First way is, you can just think for the number to be added to 2/117 so that the result is 0. Obviously, that will be -2/117. The second way is, you can subtract this number from 0. That is, you have to subtract 2/117 and you are getting -2/117. That is known as additive inverse of 2/117. In general, take the opposite sign of the given rational number, you will get the additive inverse. Can you think for multiplicative inverse on the similar track? Try. How can you find multiplicative inverse? Yes, if we multiply any two rational numbers and the product is 1, then each number is known as multiplicative inverse of the other. Like for these two numbers, which we tried for additive inverse, let us try to find the multiplicative inverse for these. The first number is -3/4. The multiplicative inverse of this rational number will be 4/-3. Let us try to write in standard form, so it will be -4/3. We are just going to take this minus sign in numerator. The second rational number is 2/117. We are interested to find the multiplicative inverse of this number. That will be reciprocal of this number. that is 117 by 2 is the reciprocal of 2 upon 117. Again, there are many ways to keep it in our mind. If we are interested to find the multiplicative inverse of rational number a by b, it is simple. Write its reciprocal, that is b by a. Let us just think for special situations. My question for you is it possible for every rational number to have its multiplicative inverse? Think, is it so? Again, let me just repeat. Is it possible for every rational number to have its multiplicative inverse? Okay, think for 0. 0 is a rational number because 0 can be written as 0 by 1. Is it possible for us to write the multiplicative inverse? That will be 1 by 0. That is not possible because 1 by 0 is not defined. So we have this number, a particular rational number, which does not have its multiplicative inverse. Now, let us just take another situation. We are interested to see, is there any rational number which is equal to its multiplicative inverse? Yes, think, try. Can you find any rational number which is equal to its multiplicative inverse? Okay, let me make this statement simple. Do you have any rational number which is equal to its reciprocal? There can be more than one. Yes, it is correct. 1 and minus 1. These are two rational numbers which are equal to their multiplicative inverse. Okay, children, now let us think for the next property, that is associativity. You have heard this word? Yes, you are familiar. Because in natural numbers, in whole numbers, we tried this property. Let us just develop the understanding about associativity for rational numbers. For associativity, we have to take three rational numbers. Let us take the rational numbers a by b, c by d, and e by f. We are just going to find the sum of two rational numbers a by b and c by d first. Then to the sum, we are just going to add e by f. Or we can just take in a different manner. First, we can take the sum of two rational numbers c by d and e by f first. And to the sum, we can add a by b. Is the total sum in these two situations same? You try. It is same. You can take many situations, many sets of three rational numbers in your notebook. You can try. Every time you will find that the sum of three rational numbers will be same if we are going to add them in any order. So here we conclude addition is associative for rational numbers. Now let us just discuss about subtraction. Whether subtraction is associative for rational numbers or not. Let us take three different rational numbers like minus 2 by 3, minus 4 by 5, and 1 by 2. We are just going to subtract minus 4 by 5 from 2 by 3 first, and from this difference, let us subtract half. And we are just going to retain this result. In the second situation, what are we doing? We are just going to subtract half from minus 4 by 5 and we are just going to subtract this difference from minus 2 by 3. Is the result same? No. The result is different in these two situations. And which is the conclusion for us? Subtraction is not associative for rational numbers. We are just going to take many more examples and we are just going to conclude by ourselves. When we just check these results by our own, then we develop the good understanding about these properties and we can apply them easily in questions and we can think differently. So, you are just going to try associativity for division by your own and conclude. You will just tell me whether division is associative for rational numbers or not. Now, riddle time. I am a 3-digit number. Listen carefully. My unit's digit is greater than hundreds digit. My tens digit is an even number. My double is more than 1000. Find me, tell me, and have a fun. After riddle time, you are just going to apply today's property for exercise 1.1 and 1.2. Discuss with your friends. Enjoy. Be happy and just gain confidence. You can do wonderful things. See, today we just enjoyed a lot.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants Meenakshi Kukreti and Tanu Gupta. Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.